Clinton nightmare, Uranium One informant has video of briefcases full of cash. Well, well, well. What have we here? As if Hillary Clinton is not in enough trouble already? Her Trump-Russia collusion narrative and her fake Trump dossier both fell apart, and now this. As if we didn't know there was some kind of pay-to-play scandal behind the whole Uranium One dealing with Russia in the first place, right? I mean, come on. Let's face it, Hillary Clinton would sell her soul for money if she could. The former FBI Assistant Director James Kallstrom has already stated that he thinks Hillary has committed crimes 20x worse than President Richard Nixon did during Watergate. There is no doubt Hillary was selling assets and stashing cash in the Clinton Foundation while she was Secretary of State during the Obama administration, with her pay-to-play dealings from various contributors and foreign countries, including Russia. There is also no doubt that former President Obama had to know about this too. Bribes, kickbacks, and a shocking video are just some of the proof. Of course, Americans weren't supposed to know about this because, as we all know, Hillary Clinton was supposed to win the election. Oops. And as far as the key eyewitness involved, well, he was threatened to keep his mouth shut and had to sign a non-disclosure form. What a surprise. Why is it that people with power always think they are above the law? I guess with Hillary, there's always a price. On Thursday, investigator John Solomon appeared on Hannity and claimed that an informant witnessed briefcases full of cash intended to be transferred between Russia and the Clintons. He gathered so much information. There are videotapes where the Russians are opening up briefcases full of cash. These are the people that we then gave uranium to, that we then gave nuclear fuel contracts to, Solomon explained. According to Reuters, that informant is William D. Campbell, a man who worked as a lobbyist for a Russian firm. If his evidence is solid, Bill and Hillary Clinton should be very worried. Campbell is scheduled to testify before Congress next week. Let's hope the William Campbell makes it until next week. Do you remember the last time someone was supposed to testify against the Clintons? Well, like John Ash. Many suddenly turn up dead before their trials. What a surprise, right? Yeah, I'm sure the Clintons thought so too. Another bombshell. What a surprise. Not. If anyone has been paying attention, you know this informant was silenced until after the election. Again, Democrats and Hillary never thought she would lose the presidential election. All of these scandals, including Uranium One, were going to be just swept under the rug, like all the rest of Hillary's scandals, including the email server and her deleted emails. It is very surprising, to say the least, that this informant's name was released by AG Sessions. How wild is that? I would not want to be in this guy's shoes, would you? I mean, we all know people involved with the Clintons seem to have a way of dying from a self-inflicted wound to the back of their head under very coincidental circumstances. This informant is battling not only cancer, but battling for his life now that his name is out there. It wouldn't shock me if he suddenly falls ill and conveniently passes away. Look at the previous people involved in cases against the Clintons. They are dead: Seth Rich, Sean Lucas, Bernie Wisenant, and others. The Clinton body count just continues to grow. Were there bribes and cash involved? Absolutely. Did this involve Hillary taking kickbacks for the Clinton Foundation? Absolutely. Was this extortion? Absolutely. Russia probably laughed all the way to the bank on this deal. Thank goodness there are still a few good men and or women left in the FBI that still believe there was not equal justice when it came to Hillary Clinton and all her scandals. Thank goodness Hillary Clinton didn't win the presidential election. Thank goodness we have evidence and a witness. Now the real question is, will this informant make it to the trial? There seems to be quite a few people that were supposed to testify against the Clintons that conveniently never made it to their trial. Here's just some of the names. On June 22, 2016, John Ash, a former United Nations diplomat from Antigua, died at his Dobbs Ferry, New York, home. According to various accounts, Ash's death occurred just 5 days before he was set to stand trial on corruption charges. Ash's cause of death was initially misreported as a heart attack, but subsequent news accounts attributed his demise to a weightlifting accident. How convenient for Hillary, right? James McDougal, Clinton's convicted Whitewater partner died of an apparent heart attack while in solitary confinement. He was a key witness in Ken Starr's investigation. Vince Foster, a former White House counselor and colleague of Hillary Clinton at Little Rock's Rose Law Firm, died of a gunshot wound to the head, ruled a suicide. Ron Brown, former Secretary of Commerce and former DNC chairman, was reported to have died by impact in a plane crash. A pathologist close to the investigation reported that there was a hole in the top of Brown's skull resembling a gunshot wound. At the time of his death, Brown was being investigated, and spoke publicly of his willingness to cut a deal with prosecutors. On July 3, 2016, Sean Lucas and filmmaker Ricardo Villalba served the DNC Services Corporation and chairperson Debbie Wasserman Schultz at DNC's headquarters in Washington, D.C., in the fraud class action suit against the Democrat Party on behalf of Bernie Sanders' supporters. Sean Lucas was found dead that week. Lucas' death followed the death of 27-year-old Democratic staffer Seth Conrad Rich, who was murdered in Washington, D.C. on July 10. The killer or killers appear to have taken nothing from their victim, leaving behind his wallet, watch, and phone. I think you get the picture.